Welcome to the very first episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm Patrick, and I'm thrilled to be here with my fantastic host, Sweta.
Co-host, Patrick.
Co-host, yeah. This is your go-to spot for everything Microsoft Fabric, whether you're an MVP, a super user, or simply someone using Fabric to solve real-world challenges. We want to hear from you. This show is all about connecting with community, sharing insights, and learning from each other.
That's right, Patrick. Each week, we will dive into key topics that matter to the data community, from breaking down complex data silos to exploring cutting-edge features that are super tailored with demos to each topic, so you can see firsthand how these tools work in action. Whether you're just starting your journey with Fabric or you're already a pro, there is something here for everyone. Plus, we have subject matter experts ready to answer your Q&A live, so don't hesitate to start asking your questions anytime during the show.
Okay, and we want to make you part of this conversation. If you're an MVP, a super user, or someone using Fabric in your day-to-day work, we love to have you as a guest on this show. Our goal is to learn from you, showcase how you're using Fabric to make an impact and help others in the community to grow with us.
Exactly, and today we are diving into a topic that's on the minds of so many. From data chaos to unified power, the story behind Microsoft Fabric. This episode will give you a sneak peek into how Fabric is transforming data and simplifying the complex challenges of managing data across organizations. And we are thrilled to have Arun with us. He's the Corporate Vice President of Azure Data and Microsoft Fabric at Microsoft. Arun, thank you so much for joining us today.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. I'm so excited to be here.
Okay, Arun, let's rewind a bit. Right. I have been on this Fabric Power BI journey. I've been on this journey, this data journey for a long time. And so how did Fabric come to be? What's the story behind it?
Yeah, it was a few years ago. It was the summer of 2021. And we were trying to imagine what the future of the data and AI stack was going to look like. And we spent a lot of time talking to customers. And one of the things that came up over and over again is really the sheer amount of complexity that customers were confronted every single day. There's literally hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of products and technologies in what everybody refers to as the modern data and AI stack, right? And the burden is on customers to figure out which products to use, which ones work together, and how do you put them together to create business value. So we thought, well, what if we could think about a much better world for customers? And we thought about a few principles. Right? The first is we said, let's put a complete data platform together. And one of the nice things about having a complete data platform is Microsoft has a lot of intellectual property and products that we can bring to the table. We had Azure Data Factory, we had Azure Synapse Analytics, we had Power BI, we had a very strong database portfolio, we had Azure Data Lake Gen 2, so we had a lot of the core technologies that comprise the data and AI stack. So we said, hey, let's put it all together, right? Similar to how Office came to be by putting Word, PowerPoint, Excel. Like I said, we can do the same thing. That's number one. Number two, we said, hey, why should things be so hard to build? What if we move from the world of platform as a service, where we give people parts and have them put the solution together, to the world of software as a service, where things just work and developers can focus on moving their business forward? That was the second big idea. The third big idea was just around one lake, right? Because data lakes are very messy and complicated. They're nothing more than storage accounts provisioned by developers. And Amir Netz, who I think you're going to talk to in the show, had this big idea. He said, what if data lakes could be as simple as OneDrive is for documents, right? So he came up with the idea of One Lake. And believe it or not, the name One Lake was taken. So we had to pay some people in Europe a lot of money so that we could actually use the name One Lake.
Okay.
But that's what we did, you know? So when we really thought about how we can simplify the data and, you know, the data lake infrastructure, that was point number three.
Yeah.
Point number four is really about business users. Because what's the point of data sitting beautifully in a lake if business is not using it? So we really thought about how do we empower business with Power BI, with Excel, with Teams, with all of the functionality that is built into Office, right? And the last one is really thinking about the business model. You know, we just think the data and AI stack is too expensive for customers because they have to buy a million different things, and they're expensive, and they're not terribly well utilized. So we really had this idea of saying, hey, what if you just buy one thing, right? Just Fabric Compute, and all the computers virtualized, all of it is serverless, and you can use it where it needs to go, right? So that's the idea. And we tested this with customers, Patrick, and the reaction was off the charts, right? And then the question was, like, can you pull it off, right? Because it was a very attractive vision, but there's a lot of technical complexity to make it happen. And then, you know, we're hard at work, we're hard at work, we're hard at work. And guess what? ChatGPT happens, right? And then we recognize that the world just changed.
Yeah.
And then AI just took off like a rocket. And it also put massive pressure on us because we felt like, hey, we have to get a product ready. We have to get it ready in time. We have to get it ready at high quality so that we can catch this wave. Otherwise, customers are going to make choices without Microsoft being in the game. So that's kind of how the Fabric idea was born. Wow. And that's the journey that we've been on for the last few years. Exciting.
That's an exciting journey.
That's great, Arun. So, since the inception of Fabric, Arun, how is it going?
It's growing like crazy, Swetha. It's really, really growing very quickly. Satya shared in our last earnings call that we are over 19,000 customers who are currently using Fabric. And that's just within about a little more than 12 months after it became generally available. He also called out the fact that Fabric is the fastest growing analytics product that Microsoft ever launched, period, right? So it's growing like crazy. What's also exciting is really how customers are using Fabric, right? Because Fabric is an end-to-end product, we're finding that more than half the customers are using 3+ workloads in Fabric. Guess what the most common workloads are? People are using Data Factory to bring data into Fabric, into one lake typically. Then they're using either Spark or SQL to transform it, and then they're using Power BI, right? So that's the most common pattern. But we're also finding that more than 20% of our paying customers are using every workload in Fabric, right? So no matter where they start, because Fabric is designed as an end-to-end product, customers end up using more and more workloads because it is just so easy, it's built in. We're also seeing that as customers are making the transition to the era of AI, they really, really need a data platform that brings the data together, that unifies the data, and that can scale. So Fabric is really just getting built into a lot of the new AI projects that customers are working on. So it is growing like crazy.
That's amazing, Arun. You did mention about some workloads, but tell us about the recently made generally available Fabric real-time intelligence.
Yeah, this is an exciting one, Swetha, because here's a challenge, right? Most of the customers on the planet, most of the people, when they work with data, they're working with data that is at best a day old. Often it's a week old, often it's a month old. You can think about working with data that's a week or a month or even a day old as like driving a car by looking at the rearview mirror, right? Now, how well are you going to be able to drive?
Exactly.
But there's so much data flowing in all the time. Mm-hmm. Data from IoT devices, data from applications, data from logs, data, telemetry data flowing in. But traditionally, it's been very, very hard to work with real-time data. You have to do very complicated things like spin up Spark clusters and stand up Kafka, clusters, and write lots and lots of code to get to business value, which means that customers generally don't work with real-time data. Most of the time, they're working with batch data. And so with Fabric Real-Time Intelligence, we make it drop-dead simple. Just like every part of Fabric, we can work with real-time data everywhere, not just data in Azure. Of course, we do a great job supporting that, but data from any Kafka cluster, real-time data flowing in from AWS Kinesis, from Google PubSub. But we make it really, really simple to work with the real-time data. And really get to business value. So it became generally available last November, and we're seeing customers like Johnson's Controls, Taco Bell, Emirates really take after this because they're able to use real-time data in a way that they were never able to do before and get to business value very, very quickly.
That's amazing.
So I was at Ignite. You were at Ignite. Yep. There was a big announcement, and it confused me. I was a little...
You're easily confused, Patrick.
I was honestly conflicted because I've been using Fabric, and Fabric's this analytical, end-to-end data analytics solution. But then at Ignite, we introduced SQL Database.
Yes.
And tell me about that.
Yes. Well, here's the idea. The idea is that the distinctions between SQL databases, NoSQL databases, in-memory databases, analytics databases, vector databases, we believe those distinctions are disappearing very, very quickly. Mm-hmm. Because when customers are building applications, most new applications are AI applications today. Yeah. But if they're not AI applications today, they will be AI applications tomorrow. And these applications need all of these capabilities. Therefore, we really think that it makes sense for us to have one of the world's best transactional databases, which is Azure SQL, available in Fabric so that people can build applications, right? They can build applications that can scale, they can build applications that can handle really high transactional throughput, and it's all just part of Fabric. Well, what does that mean? That means it's all software as a service. Yeah. All of the data is sitting in one lake in the open source Delta Parquet format. Yep. It means that all of the data is available for all of the Fabric workloads, whether it's machine learning workloads or it's Power BI or AI workloads, it's all just immediately available. It also means that there's no integration tax. It also means that there's just a single bill to pay. So customers are absolutely loving this version. It's only in public preview, but we're already seeing thousands of customers adopt, you know, the new database capabilities just to try it out. Yeah. Right? But we're not stopping with Azure SQL. We're going to add Cosmos DB. We're going to bring PostgreSQL. Wow. So, you know, the future is exciting because Fabric is going to be a complete data platform for customers. Yeah. And we're just getting started.
Yeah, so no more end-to-end analytics. We're talking end-to-end data.
End-to-end data, yeah. Right? Because when you think about what applications need, you need a full data platform.
Yeah, absolutely.
And all of these distinctions are artificial distinctions that really came from the way products evolved. Yeah. And really, we want to make all of these capabilities available to developers.
Okay, sweat in the room. Enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my laptop.
All right, show us what you got, Patrick.
I got it.
Here I am in my Contoso Sales workspace. I will use the basic analytics pre-designed task flow to build my analytics solution. This task flow is an excellent starting point for designing and deploying various data solutions. I can also modify it to suit my organization's needs. Once I have my starting point, I can use the task flow to select the necessary items for the solution. To get started, I'll create a data warehouse to store all my data. Once the data warehouse is up and running, the next step involves using Copilot to generate the necessary T-SQL scripts for creating the tables. Rather than manually inputting the code, by simply typing a prompt, Copilot will seamlessly generate the required T-SQL scripts. After the script is ready, I can open a query window and execute the query to create the table. This method allows me to repeat the process for all other required objects, ensuring a streamlined approach to building the entire data warehouse. This method not only saves time, but also minimizes the potential for errors that can occur with manual scripting. After I've created all the tables in the data warehouse, the next step is to extract and load the data from the source. Let's return to the workspace. Click the Collect Data Task Flow item and select the Copy Job item from the recommended list. Provide a name and follow the steps. First, choose the data source that contains the data. Then select the corresponding tables. Next, select the destination, which is the Fabric data warehouse that was created in the previous section, and opt for an incremental copy to speed up subsequent data loads. Select the incremental columns for each table in the source. Finally, configure the schedule that meets your organization needs, and then click Save and Run to start copying the data from the source to the data warehouse. Once the copy job is successfully executed and all the data is loaded into the data warehouse, I will return to the data warehouse to validate the data. This can be done by manually writing T-SQL queries or using Copilot. I will, of course, use Copilot. By providing a prompt to Copilot, a query will be generated, which can then be executed to verify the accuracy and validity of the data. After the data is validated, the next step is to build a semantic model for reporting and analysis. To do this, click the New Semantic Model button, then provide a name for the model, and finally select the necessary tables from your data warehouse. Just like that, the semantic model is created. Now, directly in the web browser, you can view and modify model properties, and you can even create relationships between tables in your semantic model. Once the model is ready, I'll switch to the DAX query view and begin to add measures. Similar to writing T-SQL, I can manually write DAX because it's so easy to do. However, I'll use Copilot to create all the necessary measures. By providing a prompt, Copilot generates all the DAX required to formulate my measures. I could then execute the queries to validate both the DAX and the data. Once this process is complete, I am able to add all the measures to the model with a single click. With the model now complete, including relationships and measures, it's time to build some reports. Instead of starting from scratch, I can leverage the capabilities of Copilot to give us a strong starting point in our report design. By providing a simple prompt, Copilot can generate nearly what we need, allowing us to save valuable time and effort. This initial report can be customized and refined to meet our specific requirements, ensuring that it aligns perfectly with our analytical goals. Some charts reference the date key, but I prefer calendar year. I can continue my conversation with Copilot and ask it to make this change. And just like that, the report is updated instantly. With my report complete, I'll return to my workspace. All the parts of my solution are now complete. Now let's focus on natural language processing. I could use notebooks, experiments, or AI skills in Fabric to build this. Instead, I'll use the built-in immersive Copilot experience. By clicking the Copilot button, I can interact with my data. For example, I can ask for sales by store. Copilot quickly generates a visual that displays the answer to my question. In addition, I can ask for something more complicated, like the top 5 product sales per store. Copilot quickly produces another response to my question. And just like that, in just a few minutes, I've used Fabric to create a comprehensive end-to-end data analytics solution that collects data, stores data, visualizes data, and uses natural language to interact with data.
That's an impressive demo.
Patrick, that's my line.
Okay, so I have to go forward.
That's impressive, Patrick.
Thank you, I know.
Especially how Power BI and AI are seamlessly embedded. Yeah. It's amazing to see.
Yeah.
It's also cool to see how like AI just accelerates the entire development process, right? Because Fabric, the AI capabilities is just built into every workload, so you can get to solutions so much more quickly.
So honestly, when I was building it, you know, I had to write all these SQL scripts over and over, create table. But instead of me, you know, writing those scripts, I was more efficient because it generated it for me, and it lessened my likelihood of creating errors or doing things that I shouldn't do. And it increased the time. It made me more efficient.
That's incredible, Patrick. So Arun, what does the future look like for Microsoft Fabric?
It's incredibly exciting, Sweta. There's 3 things to think about. The first is really democratizing all of these really, really complicated technologies. Well, as excited as I am about the 19,000 customers we have for Fabric, it's just a drop in the bucket. You know, the opportunity for customers is so much bigger. And one example of a product where we've really driven broad access and democratized it is really Power BI, mm-hmm. which today has over 375,000 customers, right? So we want to make sure that Fabric really serves planet Earth, right? It can help every customer get value from their data and really make sure these complex, expensive technologies become much less expensive, much easier to use, and every business on the planet can leverage it. That's number one. Number two is really the opportunity to serve business users. Right? Now, business users don't wake up every morning thinking about their data. They wake up every morning thinking about their business. Mm-hmm. Right? And there's hundreds of millions of business users that use Microsoft 365, Excel, Teams, et cetera. And our opportunity is to serve them. You know, make sure that when they have questions about their data, when they want to understand what's going on, when they want to ask complicated questions about what-if analysis, et cetera, Fabric is just there, Power BI is just there, that it can answer all of these questions and empower business to move much more quickly, become much more competitive, and really get that edge that they're looking for. That, I think, is really number two, because what's the point of data sitting beautifully if nobody's using it, right? And the third opportunity is really helping customers build these AI applications, these AI workloads. And this is where we're doing a ton of work with our friends in the Azure AI Foundry team, which is our AI in our portfolio. And we really try to make it very easy for customers to mix and match Fabric and Foundry as they build the next generation of workloads. So those are the 3 areas that my team and I are working intensely on.
Wonderful.
Wow. Think about this. This is just our first video. Imagine where we're going to go, right? This is just the beginning. We'll be covering real-world use cases, expert insights, and some hands-on demos in our upcoming videos.
Fantastic.
Before we go, we are excited about Fabric Conference happening from March 30th to April 2nd. Get an exclusive sneak peek into the top reasons to attend in our upcoming episode. Don't miss it. Tune in to hear all about the things that are happening at Fabric Conference in that episode. Stay connected and catch all things FabCon at aka.ms/FabCon. See you there.
Thanks, Arun, for helping us kick off Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
Oh, thank you so much for having me. This was fun, folks. I really love doing this.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive in the Microsoft Fabric.